yesterday we have discussed some example problems, right? Now today we continue with the same. See, another example problem is that 3.6 grams of a gas, 3.6 grams of a gas at 25 degrees Celsius occupied the same volume as 0.184 grams of hydrogen at 17 degrees Celsius. And at the same temperature, same pressure they mentioned, but temperature they changed. Initially temperature was 25 degrees Celsius, finally temperature is 17 degrees Celsius. Initially, how much mass was taken? 3.7 grams was taken. Okay. And finally, how much mass here? For hydrogen gas, what is the mass taken? 0.184. For the given gas, unknown gas, how much is taken? 3.7 taken. So for unknown gas, the weight is 3.7 grams. For hydrogen gas, weight is 0.184 grams. Okay, ma. So hydrogen gas means gram molecular mass, we must know. Gram molecular mass of hydrogen, how much? 2 grams per mole. 2 grams per mole is what? Gram molecular weight. So what is temperature of hydrogen gas given here? The temperature of hydrogen gas given is 17 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the unknown gas given is what? 25 degrees Celsius. And pressure they maintain same for both gases. For unknown gas and hydrogen gas, pressure is same here. Now they asked, what is the molecular mass of the gas? For the unknown gas, what is molecular mass? We have to calculate. Okay. So in this problem now here, for hydrogen gas, we are taking first. For hydrogen gas, what is the mass given, ma? 0.184 grams. 0.184 grams is weight. Weight means what? Mass only. So weight of hydrogen given here. And next, temperature of hydrogen, how much here? 17 degrees Celsius. But in numerical problems, while solving, we must convert the centigrade temperature into Kelvin temperature, remember. So here, 17 plus 273, 290 Kelvin. Hydrogen temperature is 290 Kelvin. And gram molecular weight of hydrogen, how much? 2. Gram molecular weight is what? 2. Okay. Next, we know that PV is equal to NRT, we know. PV is equal to NRT. N means what? Number of moles. Number of moles formula what, ma? Weight by gram molecular weight. Given weight by gram molecular weight is what? Number of moles. So PV is equal to N into RT. N is what? Weight by gram molecular weight. Number of moles formula what? Given weight by gram molecular weight. Then PV of hydrogen. PV of hydrogen is equal to 0.184 grams of hydrogen weight divided by gram molecular weight of hydrogen, how much? 2. Okay. Into R value is constant enough for gas, unknown gas, R value will be same with what here? Hydrogen. For hydrogen and unknown gas, for both, R value will be same. That's why we are taking R only here. Constant. And temperature of hydrogen, how much we got here? 290 Kelvin. So this is for hydrogen gas. Now next is for unknown gas. For the unknown gas, the weight is given how much, ma? 3.7 grams given. 3.7 grams is given weight of unknown gas. Gram molecular weight, we don't know. Gram molecular weight of unknown gas, we don't know. And temperature of unknown gas is how much here? Given temperature plus 273. 25 degrees Celsius is taken for unknown gas. So 25 degrees Celsius plus 273 will give 298 Kelvin. Now again, formula of unknown gas also what? Same. PV is equal to NRT. PV is equal to N into RT. N is what? Given weight by gram molecular weight. Given weight is what here? 3.7. Given weight is 3.7 for unknown gas. And gram molecular weight is what? M. That one we have to calculate. This is for second gas. Means for first gas, hydrogen, first equation. The second equation for what? Unknown gas. Now here, equating both the equations. Both the equations. Here PV, there also PV, na? For hydrogen also we have taken P into V. For unknown gas also we are taking P into V. So we equate both the equations. Now here for the unknown gas, what is this? 3.7 weight by gram molecular weight we have to calculate into R constant and 298 Kelvin is equal to. For hydrogen gas, what now? PV 0.184 given weight by gram molecular weight of hydrogen into R. Gas constant is common and 290 is temperature of hydrogen gas. Now what can be cancelled here? R and R get cancelled here. These two get cancelled. Now what we need to calculate? This gram molecular weight of unknown gas we have to calculate. So gram molecular weight is equal to what now here? 41.33. Okay, by cross multiplication, we can get what now? Gram molecular weight of the unknown gas. So this is a process of what? Calculation of gram molecular weight of unknown gas when the remaining values are given to you. Is the concept clear? Next, another example. What is the pressure of HCl gas? HCl is what? Hydrochloric acid. This hydrochloric acid gas is taken. HCl gas is taken. What is the pressure of HCl gas, hydrogen chloride gas, at minus 40 degrees Celsius? What is temperature given here? Minus 40 degrees Celsius. Now, centigrade temperature, we should convert into what? Kelvin. So, we have to add what? 273. This minus 40 plus 273 we have to take. So, given temperature is there. For this hydrogen chloride gas, the temperature is what here? Minus 40 degrees Celsius. And pressure we have to calculate. What is the pressure? P we have to calculate. And capital T is given to you. And P value, pressure we have to calculate. So pressure is to be calculated and temperature is given. Of its density, if its density is 8 gram per meter cube, 8 kilograms per meter cube. The density is given what, Mahir? 8 kilograms per meter cube. Now it is MKS unit of density or CGS unit here. MKS unit given here. SI unit given here. Kilograms and meter. Now here, we have to convert this one into what? Gram per centimeter cube. Grams per centimeter cube we have to convert. The density should be converted into what? The units of gram per centimeter cube. But here density given what? 8 kilograms per meter cube. Okay. So the density is given to you and temperature is given. Pressure we have to calculate. And R value always you must remember. Always R value is equal to 8.314 joules, Kelvin inverse, mole inverse. Here it is what now again MKS system. Joule is what? MKS unit of R. That means R value is taken what here? Joules. Joules means what? SI unit. Okay. And now here equation for ideal gas is what? PV is equal to NRT. PV is equal to NRT. N is what again? Number of moles. Given weight by gram molecular weight. PV is equal to N into RT. N is what now? Given weight by gram molecular weight. Any given weight there here? Given weight is not there. Weight of HCl is not given. But what is given? Density is given. Density formula what generally? What is density formula? Density is equal to mass by volume. So mass by volume. Mass means what? Given weight by volume. So here given weight by volume. We'll be giving what now here? Density. Now here weight is there, now weight means mass. Weight is there and volume is there here. If you take volume this side, weight by volume means density only. So like this density concept is given to you. Density is given, pressure they asked you to calculate. Density always, we must recall that mass by volume is density. Now here PV is equal to NRT generally. From that, P is equal to. P is equal to, we have taken from previous equation, only P is taken on the left hand side and V is taken right hand side here. So volume is taken right hand side. Okay. Now here weight by volume, that is mass by volume is density. Density into RT by M. D into small, this total is what now here? Density. This total weight by volume is what? Mass by volume, density. Density into RT by M. Okay. So like this we can take here. So why the weight by volume, that is mass by volume is what? Density here. So we have taken this formula. Now given that density is equal to what? 8 kilograms per meter cube. 8 kilograms per meter cube given. And R value is taken what? In SI units. 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole. Okay. Next, temperature is what now given? Minus 40 degrees Celsius given. So minus 40 degrees Celsius plus 273. Will give Kelvin temperature. So this way, we got temperature in Kelvin and the R value is understood and density is known here. Okay. Then molecular mass, molecular gram molecular weight of hydrogen chloride, how much? Hydrogen 1, chlorine 35.5. Right, Mark? Hydrogen 1, chlorine 35.5. So 1 plus 35.5, 36.5 gram per mole. So 36.5 grams is what now? The gram molecular weight of HCl. Gram molecular weight of HCl. It is in taken grams here. But density is taken what here? Kilograms. Density is taken what? Kilograms. Is that clear, ma? Okay, we can convert this grams into kilograms, na? instead of converting this density and R value, all values into CGS, we can convert this gram molecular weight into kilogram molecular weight. That means gram, we have to convert into kilograms, that's all. So 1 kilogram is equal to how many grams? 1,000. 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. But 1 gram is equal to how many kilograms? 10^-3 kilograms. In place of gram, what we can write ma? 10^-3 kilograms. That's why here 36.5 into, in place of gram, what we have taken here? 10^-3 kilograms. So 1 gram is equal to what ma? 1 gram is equal to 10^-3 kilograms. That's why what we have taken in place of gram, what we have written? 10^-3 kilograms we have written. So we have taken SI unit here. The mass also, gram molecular weight also we have taken in kilograms. Now all are in SI units na? Okay, kilograms, here joules, here kilogram per meter cube. So all are taken in SI units. Now here substituting the values in the above equation, we can get P. The P is equal to what now here? Density into R into T divided by mass. So like this, we have to substitute all this. Then we get what now here? Pressure in SI units. What are the SI units of pressure? Pascal, PA. PA means what here? Pascal. So Pascal is the SI unit of what? Pressure. Is that clear, ma? So we get pressure value in what? Pascals. Is that clear to all? So this point we have to keep in mind. Okay. Next. Now another example is here. So in this case now, a certain quantity of a gas, a certain quantity of a gas occupies what? 100 ml. The gas, so which gas is not mentioned here? Some particular gas they mentioned, the unknown gas. So some gas has volume how much here? 100 ml. So volume is given to you here. When collected over water, over the water we have collected. Over the water means what now? It is coming under Dalton's pressure, Dalton's partial pressures. So anyhow, Dalton's partial pressure is not there, na? We will discuss this concept later. Because aqueous tension, partial pressure concept is coming under Dalton's law. Our syllabus is up to only what? Ideal gas equation. Means from where? Boyle's law will be there, Charles law will be there in syllabus, and Avogadro's law, and also what? Gay-Lussac's law. These 4 laws and ideal gas equation. Based on this only, the syllabus will be there for coming exam. So this Dalton's law we'll discuss later. Dalton's law of partial pressures, no need now. So Dalton's law is not there, and also Graham's law is not there. Dalton's law and Graham's law, these two are not there now. We'll discuss about that problems later. Okay, ma. Next. The density of a gas is given here. What is given here? This value is what density. So density is equal to what now? Mass by volume. So generally density of a gas is measured in which units I told you? Density of any gas is taken in which units? Gram per liter, remember. Gram per liter. So in gram per liter, the density of a gas is given. Which gas? They did not mention here. And what is the temperature given? Capital T is given what now here? 400 Kelvin. Already they have given in Kelvin temperature. Need not to convert. Already Kelvin temperature is mentioned here. And what is the pressure given here? 190 torr. Okay. So here in this case, what we have to do is that this torr, whenever torr or mm is given, we have to convert into atm. The given pressure in torr divided by 760. Why we have taken this conversion factor here, 190 by 760, why we have taken? Because 1 atm is equal to what? 1 atm is equal to 760 torr. 1 atm is equal to 760 torr. 1 atm is equal to 760 mm. Mm means 1 torr. 1 millimeter of mercury is equal to 1 torr pressure. T-O-R-R. That's why 1 atm is equal to 760 torr. Therefore, 190 torr, how to convert into Kelvin atm here? Given torr by 760. The given pressure in torr divided by 760. Otherwise, given pressure in millimeter divided by 760 will give in atm. Pressure will be in atm. So we have taken pressure in atm. So we know that 760 torr is equal to 1 atm. Therefore, 190 torr is equal to how many atm? So cross multiplication. So 190 into 1, 190 divided by 760 will be what now here? The pressure in atm. So pressure in what we have taken now here? Atm we have taken. When we take liters here, the volume liters when we take, the pressure should be in atm, remember. Whenever volume is taken in liters, we have to take pressure in atm. So here density is taken gram per liter. Gram per liter means mass by volume. That means volume is mentioned in which units? Liters. When volume is taken in liters, pressure should be in atm, remember. Okay, so next, what is the formula here? P is equal to drt by m. Okay, ma. So m is equal to p is equal to drt by m. And what is d formula? Pm by rt. Okay, and m is equal to what? Molecular mass is equal to what? Drt by p. So m is equal to, capital M is equal to drt divided by p. So d is what? Density. Rt divided by pressure. This will give one of molecular mass of the unknown gas. So density given what here in this problem? 0.259 gram per liter they give. Density is given in CGS units, gram per liter. And here, pressure is taken what now? Not CGS unit here. Generally, gaseous pressure will be taken in gram per liter. Actually, what is CGS unit of density generally? Gram per centimeter cube. Gram per centimeter cube generally we take. But the general unit of density of a gas is what taken? Gram per liter will be taken. Gram per liter. And pressure is given 190 torna, 190 by 760 in atm we get. And temperature is given 400 Kelvin. And R value now, what we have to take is, this is important here. R value in which units we have to take is important. So R value we discussed in different units. So here liter atmosphere. R value in what? Liter atmosphere. When we take R value in liter atmospheres, if we take volume in liters, pressure in atm. If pressure is taken in atm, volume is taken in liters, we have to take R value in what? Liter into atmosphere. Pressure into volume, P into V. Okay? Per Kelvin, per mole is common for all the units of numerical values of R. So what is the value of R in liter atmosphere? Ma? 0.0821. 0.0821 liter atmosphere, Kelvin inverse, mole inverse, and temperature given. So molecular mass is equal to what now here? DRT by P. DRT by P. By P means 190 by 760 means 760 by 190 only. Na? In the denominator, 190 by 760 means. If you invert, what happens? 760 by 190. So then we get what now here? Molecular mass. Molecular mass of the given gas, how much here? 34 grams per mole. 34 grams per mole is the gram molecular weight of unknown gas. Okay, ma'am. Next, another example. The density of oxygen is given. The density given here. What is given here? This given value is what? D. D is what now here? Density. Okay. The density of gas will be measured in which units? Gram per liter. At STP, they mentioned. STP means what is temperature? 0 degrees Celsius. STP conditions what? 0 degree Celsius means how many Kelvin? 273 Kelvin. And STP pressure how much? 1 atm. 1 atm means 1 bar, approximately 1 bar. So 1 bar, 1 atm are nearly equal. Not exactly same, but nearly same. Okay. So STP conditions means what we have to take? 1 atm, otherwise 1 bar. And what is temperature? 273 Kelvin should be taken. And determine the density of oxygen at 17 degree Celsius. Now here, STP conditions means 0 degree Celsius. 0 degree Celsius. So the STP condition, 0 degree Celsius. At 0 degree Celsius, what is the density of gas observed? 1.43 gram per liter for oxygen. And at 17 degree Celsius, what will be density of oxygen, they asked. And what is the pressure asked here? Final pressure, P2 is what? 700 torr. So P2 is given what number here? P2 is given 800 torr. And P1 is what now? STP means 1 atm. Na? STP means 1 atm. What will be P1 value? 760 torr. 760 torr. STP means 1 atm. 1 atm is equal to how many torr? 760 torr. So P1 value should be taken here 760 torr. And P2 value should be taken 800 torr. 800 torr. So here tell me P1 value how much here? P1. So P1 should be taken what now? 760 torr we have taken because STP they mentioned here. So 760 torr. 760 torr is what now? It is P1 value. And P2 value given what here? P1 value, P2 value given what? 800 torr. So 800 torr, 760 torr. And T1 is what? 0 degree Celsius. It is T1. T1 means what to take here? 0 degree Celsius plus what? 273. Plus 273 we have taken. T1 given, P1 given. And P2 given, T2 given. Okay. Now, initial density given, D1. And final density we have to get. D2 we have to calculate here. So D2 means what now? Final density at given temperature and pressure. So what is density we have to calculate now at final conditions. Is that clear, ma'am? Now, first, at STP, initial conditions, at STP conditions, at P1 and T1, P1 is what here, 760 torr, and T1 is what, 273 Kelvin. 273 Kelvin temperature and 760 torr pressure. At this condition, what is density formula generally? Pm by RT, P into M by RT. This formula we have to remember. Density of a gas is given by the formula P into M divided by R into T. Pm by RT we have taken. So here, M is what? Constant. Gram molecular mass of oxygen. Initially, oxygen is taken. Finally, also oxygen only. The oxygen gas is changed from 0 degree Celsius to 70 degree Celsius. The gas is same. That's why M is constant. Mass is constant here. Molecular mass is constant for the same gas. R also constant. And pressure P1 given. And T1 temperature. Okay. So P1 at STP how much? 760 torr. T1 at STP how much? 273 Kelvin. And D1 given how much? 1.43. Now M and R will be constants. M and R will be gram molecular weight and R will be constant. And at given conditions, what is D2 formula? P2M by RT2. P2M by RT2. M is what? Constant. R is constant here. And M2 is, P2 is what? Now final pressure. T2 is final temperature. So final pressure is given what? 800 torr. And final temperature is given 290 Kelvin. Why? 17 plus 273. 17 plus 273 will be equal to what? 290 Kelvin. And final density we have to calculate. Density value we have to calculate. Concept clear so far, ma? So now we have formula what now here? We have to take ratio of D2 and D1. D2 by D1 ratio we have to take from the formula. So then we get what now here? 1.417 gram per liter. 1.417 gram per liter. Okay. So the density finally we have calculated. So this formula we have to apply. Okay. I will send you this PPT. Go through each and every problem. You again do once again on your own. Just read the question properly and what are the given values and how to calculate. First you get an answer on your own. Then you check it. From material also you have to. I'm giving you example problems only. Based on these models, many problems are there in your material. That all you have to do. Now, another important concept is that an open flask. Open flask. Some open flask is there. It is not closed. Contains air. Air is what? Gas here. At what temperature? T1 temperature. So at T1 temperature. T1 temperature means what we have to take? Kelvin we have to take. 27 plus 273 Kelvin we have to take. Next, calculate the temperature at which? Means what? T2 we have to calculate. What we have to calculate here? T2. Now calculate the temperature at which, okay, it should be heated so that one third of air measured at 27 degrees Celsius escapes out. Okay, now T1 is given here. What they're asking, calculate the final temperature T2 at which it should be heated. Okay, to what temperature it should be heated? The air should be heated to what temperature? So that one third of air measured at initial condition, 27 degrees Celsius, escapes out. Okay, so the gas escaped, we have to calculate. The gas escaped, we have to calculate. Now see here, let the initial number of moles of air at initial temperature, at T1 temperature is what, suppose N. At T1 temperature, initially number of moles, how many? N. N means 1N. 1N, 1 into N. So N is number of moles at what temperature? 300 Kelvin, initial temperature. Number of moles of air left, okay, when the air is heated to final temperature. To the final temperature when air is heated, okay, the number of moles will be what now here? 2N by 3. 2N by 3. One third is to be escaped, na? One third of initial value. One third of initial number of moles should be escaped. Okay, initially n there. From n, how much should be escaped? 1/3 of n. 1/3 of n means n by 3 only, na? N by 3 should be escaped. Now, initially available n minus n by 3. We have to take here. Is it clear, ma? So, we get what 2n by 3 will be the number of moles of air left over at final temperature. That final temperature we have to calculate now. The final moles left over how much? 2n by 3. Initial moles taken how much? N. Initial temperature how much? 27 plus 273, 300 Kelvin. Final temperature we have to calculate. Is it clear, ma? Now here, N1 T1 is equal to N2 T2 formula we had applied, remember. So we had applied which formula here? In this case of open vessel concept, N1 T1 is equal to N2 T2. N1 is what initially taken N into T1 how much? 300 is equal to N2 left over how much? 2N by 3 into final temperature T2 we have to calculate. This T2 we have to calculate. Okay, ma? Then T2 is equal to what now here? 177 Kelvin. First we get the T2 value in Kelvin. This Kelvin should be converted again into centigrade temperature if they ask you. If options are given in centigrade temperature, what we have to do? This T2 value again we have to convert into centigrade temperature. So whatever we get, T2 value 450 minus 273 will give centigrade temperature. So this way we have to calculate what now? The number of moles. Number of moles we have to calculate. Okay. It is about what now here? The open vessel concept. Remember. So the remaining problems we'll discuss tomorrow. I will send you this PPT. You go through that thoroughly. And now I'm giving chance to unmute yourself now. Okay, so you have to clarify doubts if any. Just a moment. Now you can unmute yourself and you can talk to me. We have you all understood what we discussed so far? Whatever we have discussed so far, did you understand, ma? Yeah, so now are you all doing the problems from material? Just raise your hands at least, those are doing. Those who are not doing anyhow will not raise hand. Are you doing bits from material or not? Please do the material bits, okay? Do not waste time. Okay, ma'am.